welcome to Women's Footy. I'm Clint Stanaway. Great to have your company on this Sunday morning, wherever you may be watching around this great country of ours. Let's get stuck into it. So much to talk about. Join my co-host, Lauren Wood. It's been a great few days, hasn't it, Lauren?
It certainly has, Clint. Great to be back with you. We've had three fantastic games already and one to go this afternoon. Can't wait.
And our special co-host from the Collingwood Footy Club, Steph Chiocci. G'day,
hello.
Steph.
Good morning. How are you?
Well, good, good. History repeated itself. Big crowd on Friday night, but unfortunately for you, a loss.
Yeah, unfortunately we didn't get the 4 points, but great crowd in, great atmosphere, and we'll have to have a look at that game and rectify it for this weekend.
We'll do it. We'll pick it apart very shortly. A big, big show, jam-packed, in fact. We've got Carlton superstar Darcy Vessio. Melbourne's Lily Mithen will be in the house and joining us very, very shortly. So too the GWS coach, Alan McConnell, and also Alicia Eva. But let's start off by backtracking and having a look at the results so far in round one. Of course, it all started on Friday night. It was a win to the Carlton Footy Club at Icon Park, a big, big crowd, as Steph said. Melbourne charging back to get the points, 6-point win over the GWS, and then the Lions, of course, upsetting the reigning premiers in Adelaide, a bit of revenge there in the grand final replay. It was a fantastic night to kick things off, Lauren.
Yeah, it was huge. We're just seeing some vision now of the crowd. They were waiting outside Icon Park from about 4 o'clock onwards, so they certainly made the most of the fantastic night of weather that it was there on Friday. They're absolutely streamed in huge numbers, out on picnic blankets outside watching it on the screen, and they got a fantastic night of footy. We're just seeing, of course, too, the flag being unfurled, so there was plenty happening across all of the grounds across the weekend. So certainly a great weekend of footy so far.
Round one, there must have been nerves churning. What was it like for you to get back out there, Steph?
Yeah, a few nerves. I think we were more excited. I think we were better prepared this year, knowing what to expect. And unfortunately for us, we just couldn't finish the job. And I think we were leading in most of the key stats, but unfortunately not on the scoreboard. So happy with how we performed, but disappointed with the loss.
The big story to come out of round one so far involves a teammate of yours, Sarah Darcy, involving this kick that we're about to see. It may well be referred to the tribunal, potentially. Is this out of character for her?
Yeah, extremely out of character. Sarah Darcy plays the game fairly. She's a really quiet and reserved kid. So, look, she'll be disappointed with that footage, but we'll have to leave it up to the match review panel to see where that goes.
What do you think their interpretation will be, Lauren? It's a big, big test first up for Michael Christian, who's the new boss of the MRP.
It is. We've seen it all overhauled, of course, in recent months. The new MRO, as he is, no more panel anymore, is the match review officer. So he'll get stuck into it tomorrow. It'll be assessed along with all of the other incidents that come out of the weekend. And I guess it's going to be an interesting one because, of course, there's no fines in the AFL women's. Being only semi-professional at this stage, there's no fines available. So if she is hit with anything, it will have to be a suspension. So it'll be really interesting to see how he assesses it. We're just seeing it now. She was, of course, reported on the spot for that one. And, you know, Sarah said afterwards it hurt. She's glad she wasn't a boy, I think was the phrase that she used. So I guess we've just got to wait, exactly like Sarah, until tomorrow.
And how was Sarah after the game?
Yeah, look, she was disappointed and, you know, she had her teammates getting around her, obviously, and she'll reflect on that. But like I said, it's a waiting game now and hopefully she's available for selection and, you know, can repay us and play some good footy.
What about last night? Revenge is best served cold, and in the interest of the Brisbane Football Club, they got the job done over the premiers. This would have been a great feeling for the Lions, Lauren.
It would have been. Of course, it wasn't quite a grand final, so I'm sure they'll be hunting revenge of the ultimate kind in a few weeks' time. But nice for them. We're just seeing them singing the song now, and they all sort of put the finger to the lips at the end of the game to silence the doubters.
Yeah, what was that about?
As it were. Yeah, well, obviously they lost to GWS by about 50 points in a pre-season game, and, you know, maybe they didn't think that people were talking them up as much as they probably should have, so.
Were you impressed with what you saw, Steph?
Yeah, they were good. They moved the ball really well and really composed with the footy. And Frederick Traub obviously had a great game as well, and she was hard to stop. So, yeah, they're going to be a force to be reckoned with.
Of course, Aaron Phillips with a late withdrawal. We'll get stuck into that injury very, very shortly. But at Demonland, they're smiling, none more so than Rocky Cranston. Wasn't she sensational out there yesterday, helped win the match for the D's.
Incredible, yeah. The game was really in the balance. It was a hot afternoon out there at Casey and a really hard-fought contest there. And Rocky, as you said, she really took the game by the scruff of the neck when it needed to be and kicked a really crucial goal in the dying minutes of the game to give the Demons the win. They, of course, lost in the first round last season, so it's an interesting one.
This is interesting. This is how the captains voted in the pre-season about who they think their team will play in a grand final. As you can see there, Melbourne leading the way on 4 votes from Carlton and the Western Bulldogs. Is that a fair reflection after what you saw there yesterday, the D's?
Yeah, absolutely. Melbourne had my vote, and I think it comes down to their midfield and the way they work with each other. And those girls have played together for a very, very long time, and the way they spread the ball and move the ball, it's quite quick, and they'll be really hard to stop.
You were impressed too, Lauren, no doubt.
Absolutely, yeah. I tipped the Demons last week to take out the flag, and they were just stellar yesterday. As I said, when the pressure was on, the game was there to be won, and they did just that.
Let's get back to Friday night. It was a huge occasion. Taylor Harris, we all know about her switch in the pre-season from Brisbane. What about her game? She certainly took things to a whole new level.
Yeah, definitely. We know her contested marking was a real strength of hers when she was at the Lions, and she really, you know, she said in the pre-season that she was doing things a little bit differently and taking a lot of constructive criticism on board, and she was another one who, you know, it was a big occasion, there was a big crowd, a lot of noise, you know, an environment, Steph, that you can certainly attest to, that's new for a lot of players, but it didn't seem to faze her.
No, it didn't faze her, and I think she thrives in those types of conditions, and as we can see by the footage there, she likes to take a good mark, and she's quite strong overhead, obviously, so look, she was hard to stop and took some really crucial marks when it mattered.
She made the switch from Brisbane in the pre-season. She had a bit to say in the lead-up to this match. Let's hear from her now.
So when I walk into the club, I'm already excited to be there and I'm happy. I've had a good day, like I've done something new. Whereas in Brisbane, I suppose I was kind of in a bit of a rut. I'd rock up to training not in a great mood, and then it would kind of just, it'd be like that the whole session. Brisbane, the way it is, and everyone knows, like it's a bit chilled, and I liked that at that time. Now I'm here, I'm 100% understand that it's professional all the time.
Taylor Harris speaking there, a bit chilled, Brisbane, apparently. What do you think, Steph?
Yeah, it's interesting. I suppose they made the grand final, so they couldn't have been too chilled. But, you know, if she's made the move and it's to better her career, then good on her.
Yeah, her ex-teammates heard those comments too. We heard Caitlin Ashmore speaking to Queensland's Courier Mail a few days ago, who said she can say what she wants, but we like to keep that rubbish outside of our four walls. Good luck to her, and we'll see her in round 3.
Wow.
So that'll be one to watch for
I
sure.
I like it. Sensational. Thanks, Lauren. Plenty of images caught our eye through the weekend already, including this from Jess Hosking. This is interesting. This is the girls singing a song, and copped one in the nose. Yeah. Blood nose.
It was a big night for the sisters, of course, sharing the field for Carlton for the first time. But, yeah, it got a bit bigger when I think she might have copped an elbow in the circle. It didn't seem to faze her, though. Of course, they'd won the game, so she wasn't too worried.
Absolutely. And great scenes here. This is sent in from our old mate, Tony Chompers Jones, all the way from South Korea, Pyeongchang, where the Winter Olympics are in action in the next week or so. Look at that. Beautiful scenes as the camera pans around. What's he watching? There we go. It's women's footy. Great to see. Tony Jones, a big fan.
Yeah,
Steph.
It is good to see. And, you know, the beauty of social media and the app now and the internet, you can watch the game anywhere around the world.
Hopefully he's keeping those teeth nice and warm in the cold. Let's head over to the McCafe, the home of the finest barista-made coffee, Lily Mithen. Good morning to you.
Good morning to you. Thanks for having me.
Big smile on your face because the D's got the job done. Eventually, a few nervous moments though in that first half.
Definitely. It was a hot contest yesterday afternoon, and yeah, luckily we just held on. GWS were excellent, and I guess our leaders through the midfield just stood up when it mattered and took the 4 points home.
Back here on Channel 9, we've seen your exploits, including the grand final footy show review. Take us back to this moment. Lily Mithen, you were an absolute star.
That is very embarrassing to watch back, but I guess it's a good laugh for all of you to have. I'm not sure I'm getting much joy out of it.
Steph, what do you make of those moves?
Yeah, I was overseas at the times, and I did watch it whilst I was overseas, and I was really, really impressed. So football skills and dance skills, what a combo.
A budding young journalist too. You're doing a bit of work on the, or have done a bit of work on the Geelong website. Let's check that out right now.
But we're back here for Mitho's Minute. I got clobbered way too many times, but come and have a look who's here.
Welcome to Mitho's Minute. Really well played today. How did you find the day?
That was good. Thank you for tuning in to Mitho's Minute once again. It's been a pleasure, as I said earlier. Tune in next year. I look forward to seeing you all then.
Mitho's Minute. Hates the camera, Lily Mithen, don't you?
I hate it. I'm so nervous. Some really interesting kits that I was wearing in those clips you just had up. There was a beanie, there was some terrible hairdos, but I guess the cameras, They just get me.
All right, well, tell us what you think on social media. We've got Facebook, Instagram, and also Twitter, Women's Footy AFL. We'll be back with Lily Nithin after this short break, as well as Carlton superstar Darcy Vesio. That's all to come here on Women's Footy. Relief for the Demons yesterday at home in front of their adoring fans. They were challenged in the first half by the much improved Giants, but they got the chocolates and were singing the song at the end of the day. Superstar Lily Nithin joins us. G'day, Lily.
Hey, Clint.
Were you happy with yesterday, obviously?
Indeed. It's always good to get the win, and probably wasn't the prettiest win, but testament to GWS. They were so good and they've come such a long way from where they left off last year, and it was a really hard-fought contest. So just good enough to get the win, which we were stoked about, but yeah.
Here's the result here. Obviously a win by 6 points. Lauren, did you like what you saw?
Definitely. It was a really hard-fought contest, as we mentioned earlier, and it was hot out there at Casey Fields, but yeah, you were under a lot of pressure there, Lil, as the game got into the dying minutes. They really came at you, but you held on.
Yeah, it was just, I think our leaders really stood up when it mattered, and we stood up when they kept coming and coming, and we just kind of grinded away and got the win in the end. So it definitely wasn't easy, and any win's a win and we'll take it, but it was definitely hard fought.
Your skipper, Daisy Pearce, she took some really, really great marks when, as I said, the game was there to be won, and you must have been pleased to see the ball in her hands, I should say, when the pressure was on.
Definitely. I was actually meant to go on in a midfield rotation, and one of the guys said, take Daisy off, Lil, you're on. And I said, no, Daisy can stay out there, she'll win us the game. So, and exactly after that, she took the sort of that hanger in the middle of the ground, and that was almost all we needed.
Hey, Lil, when the game was there to be won, one lady stood up, and that was Rocky Cranston. She was sensational. We're seeing some highlights here. Did you love what she had to offer?
Definitely. She's we've said it during the pre-season, she's put so much time and effort into her game.
That
she's
got
so much fitter and faster. She's so explosive when she's got the footy. It's really exciting when she's got the ball because we know she's going to do something with it. And she was phenomenal yesterday. To kick three and the match winner was something pretty special.
She was great. And another really good highlight for your team was Kate Hall, who was one of your draftees. I take it she was from Siebel Sandringham basketballer. What does she bring to your team?
She's just so energetic. She's that live wire across half forward and got great sort of pressure inside 50. I think she had 4 shots on goal. She only kicked one, but to have that many opportunities to score is something pretty phenomenal, and she'll continue to build on that. And with a good bit of composure and experience down there working with the girls, she'll be a really dangerous player for us in the future. So I'm loving what Kate's bringing, and she's a pretty good chick too.
Now, I can't let this go on any longer without getting an update on my girl, Karen Paxman, who I'm a very big fan of her work, obviously runner-up in the league BNF last year. But she was on fire early. I think she had 8 touches in the first couple of minutes, and then a back spasm, was it? She had to be helped from the field and then didn't return. Is she all right?
Yeah, I think she should be okay. She'll probably get a scan sometime today to see where she's at, but hopefully nothing too serious. She was in a bit of pain post-game, but nothing too bad, as I said. She was on fire, though. I think she had 4 in the first minute and was almost one of her best players, regardless that she only spent 10 minutes on the ground. But hopefully she'll be right because she is a crucial part of our team.
Must have been nice, though, to obviously get the job done without her. She's such a crucial part of your midfield, so you probably take heart from the fact that you still got the job done.
Definitely take confidence in the fact that we still won and won gutsy without her, because we do really rely on her 4-quarter running performance, and when it is getting a bit tough, we love watching Paxi inspire us girls as she runs down the wing and really gut runs. So to win without her was a massive credit to the girls to step up and do it without her.
All right, Lil, let's have a look at the votes now for our Tyre Power Player of the Year, and Steph Kiocchi, the floor is yours.
Yeah, so I went with 5 for Rochelle Cranston, Rocky there. 3 clutch goals, or 2 in the last quarter. That pick-up was phenomenal. Daisy's mark in the centre of the ground, she really led the way through there. And I think junior Elise O'Day was a clearance specialist throughout the day. And obviously my old mate there, Alicia Eva, gets the one vote for me. I think something like 11 tackles.
Thanks to Tyre Power. Buy three, get one free on selected Falcon tyres. Thanks to the team at Tyre Power. All right, Lily, let's talk more about Geelong. I know you have been asked and probably will be asked a few more times yet this season, but we know that Geelong is coming into the competition. You play for the VFLW side. Where does your heart lie?
Yeah, great question. Really loving the opportunity down there at the VFL, and it's great to see the AFL expanding the league and more girls getting that opportunity. But I'm just, really looking forward to hopefully winning a few more games with the Ds for this season and seeing where that takes me. But I guess my aim is playing good footy and seeing where that takes me in 2019. My goal is to be playing AFL, depending on what colours is in. But yeah, that's another time to worry about.
It must be fantastic for you, though, developing your own game, obviously part of an AFL environment in the women's competition, and then going back to what's essentially an AFL environment in the winter time down at Geelong, and, you know, wandering the hallways with Joel Selwood and Paddy Dangerfield.
Yeah, it is. I'm really lucky in that sense. I'm going from one elite environment to the other, and I've been really fortunate to head back there and not sort of take a backward step. So Geelong are running a really professional environment down there and gearing themselves up for that AFL team. And yeah, I've loved my time there, and it'll be good to go back there post AFLW.
Well, your pathway is a very interesting one. Take us back to under 14s. What happened that year?
Under 14s was a good year.
Yeah.
won the league best and fairest against the boys. Dad dropped me off late to the vote count. I think it was at round six or something, and I'd already won, and no one could catch me from there. So it was, that was a great year. Probably one of the better years of my footy career, and one I'll never forget.
Was it a case of you were late because somebody rang you and said, you better get down here, or?
No, just typical dad. you know, he doesn't quite know how scheduling works sometimes. I would have preferred mum to drop me off at that session on that occasion. But dad just picked me up late, and by the time we got there, it was all done and dusted.
Well, Lil, thanks for joining us on Women's Footy this morning, and we wish you and the Demons all the best for 2018.
Thanks, Clint. Go Dees.
Go Dees indeed. All right, thanks so much to Lily Miss, and she's one to watch in 2018. All right, still to come here on Women's Footy, Darcy Vesio to come to analyse Carlton's big win over the old enemy, plus standing by in the cafe, it is from the GWS, their coach and star player, Elise Eva. That's to come this morning on your Sunday morning's Women's Footy. Hello again, welcome to Women's Footy on this Sunday morning. Great to have your company. Of course, the Giants just yesterday falling just short to the Demons. The coach and superstar, Alicia Eva, joins us right now. Guys, thanks for joining us. To you, Alan, first, your thoughts on yesterday. Obviously, a great first half and just overrun in the second.
I thought we were good, but across the board, they're probably just 5% better in a whole range of areas. So we've got a bit of work to do because we don't want to just make up the numbers in the comp.
How'd you find it out there, Alicia?
It was tough. It was really hard fought, as Lily said before. And look, we were bitterly disappointed that we didn't come away with a win. And, you know, the ball could have bounced another way and the result could have been different. But we're really happy with the processes and the boxes that we've ticked so far. So, you know, we move forward and take on Carlton next week.
Steph, a player certainly caught your eye yesterday. Tell us about that.
Yeah, Phoebe McWilliams, I've just noticed she looks a lot fitter. Has a role change from last year. Obviously, you weren't there last year, but she kicked three goals and was quite pivotal.
Yeah, look, I think we've changed our structure ahead of the ball to last year, playing three tall forwards. So that probably takes a little bit of pressure off her. But that said, I think Phoebe's probably had her... She's probably been our most consistent trainer over the entire preparation. You know, she's performed really well, turned up for training in a really good mindset, you know, every night we've trained. And I think when you bring consistency to your training, you're able to bring it to the games. And so I was always confident she'd have a great game. And I think she's going to have a really, really good season.
Yeah. Alan, can you tell us a little bit about Jodie Hicks? Obviously, we've got code switches in our game now. They're becoming more and more prevalent. But Jodie's a code switcher from basically day to day. She obviously was down here yesterday for the game against Melbourne and understand she's already flown to Adelaide to fulfil her Sydney Sixers duty. So you've got to share her a little bit.
Yeah, we're a little bit that way. And Ali Brush is heading back to Sydney this morning to play at maybe 50 minutes in a W game this afternoon. So, it's a tall order for those girls, you know, particularly Jodie trying to find a way in the competition. And with her team playing in finals, it's a big deal, and so there's a lot going on for her at the moment.
And for you guys too, do you have to sort of strike a balance with, you know, how much you train them and that sort of stuff?
Yeah, like with all of those girls, we've had really, really good dialogue with their the coaches and conditioning staff from their teams and their codes. So, we work pretty hard at that. I think we come into that knowing that that's part of the deal, and looking after them so that they can perform their best in both codes is what we're about.
I said the word star before, Alicia. That's because you are the Victoria Police Recruit of the Year for this week. Of course, want to lead teams, challenge yourself and help others. Join Victoria Police. Apply today. Isn't it time? Victoria Police is now recruiting, so apply now. Alicia, your game yesterday. Were you happy with how it panned out?
I was playing a little bit of a different role this year, getting some more midfield time. So, look, I've been working really hard on my strength, well, my body around the footy, and hopefully getting my hands on a little bit more contested ball. I felt like I was tackling like a maniac yesterday, but look, I'd like to get a little bit more, I'd like to get numbers up in terms of clearances and disposal efficiency up a little bit. I felt like I was kicking a lot yesterday, but it was kind of under pressure. So I'm happy, but again, I'd like to have seen the team get the win.
What about that?
You can interpret that as she's frustrated.
Yeah.
A little bit. What about that knee of yours? I think we saw you get a little bit of a knock, but you're feeling all right this morning?
Yeah, no, I don't know what happened. I think I must have gone knee on knee or dug into the ground. So I just couldn't run. So I thought, well, I better not be one short on the ground. So I'll get off. The physio can check it. The doctor can have a look. But I'll get back on pretty quickly. So all good.
Steph, you know this young lady all too well. Of course, you pulled on the big V together, didn't you?
We did. And obviously played at the Pies together. She was my right-hand woman as my vice-captain. And yeah, a lot of respect for Leash and I love the way she goes about it. And I was really shattered when we lost her and I still remember the phone call that we had and a few tears, but we'll remain friends longer than our footy careers and, yeah, I wish her all the best.
Hey, Alan, I want to ask you about Heath Shaw, if I can, who was he's very animated at the best of times, but he was certainly doing exactly that on the bench yesterday. What has he brought to the women's team?
It's odd, isn't it? So Heath comes to the bench in the men's program and he's a raving lunatic. and he comes and sits on the bench in our program and his job is to keep things calm and relaxed and just to keep the girls' heads in the game. He's really passionate about the game. He's been involved all the way through, even with some of our recruiting and scouting early in the pre-season. He was involved and turns up to training, loves the program and loves the girls and we're really lucky to have his involvement.
Alan, you obviously have a lot to do with him, given that you hold a role in the box in the men's competition as well as coaching the women's. How big is the difference, I guess, between coaching the boys and the girls?
It's all the same.
Couldn't be more different.
No, look, to be honest, it's the same. You know, you execute the fundamentals well and you're going to be in the game. But to be honest, come game day, it's mostly about the players. I mean, I think the coach's job is fundamentally done when game comes around. You can tweak a few things, but our job is to sort of rave on a bit and sort of give the cameras a few things to look at when we're carrying on like idiots. So.
It is good, isn't it?
Yeah.
Let's check out now our Big Four goal of the year. Big Four, home of great breaks. And we start, Lauren Wood, with an Irish woman.
We do. Of course, we've seen the Irish blokes come down under and have a real impact on AFL. And it's certainly translated across to the women's with Cora Staunton ramming one home at Casey yesterday.
I've got Rochelle Cranston here. I love this goal. Early in the fourth quarter, game in the balance, picks it up one-handed, accelerates and then drills it. Yep, we're sitting right behind that.
And Steph, you mentioned Phoebe McWilliams before. She's gone off the outside of the boot here to snap one. It was an absolute cracker there from Phoebe and certainly one that's in the running to win.
A great competition with thanks to Big Four. The winner, of course, takes home $5,000, if you don't mind. Isn't it time you took a break in a Big Four holiday park? Sensational stuff and some great goals there, Alan.
Yeah, pretty good. Great to see our Irish girl get on the scoreboard. I've spoken to her this morning. She's pretty frustrated. She sort of is used to kicking five or six a game as opposed to one or two. So Yeah, I'm sure she's going to have a big influence on the season.
Well, thanks for joining us. I hope you've got some room for some excess baggage because you're going home with a few prizes, and let's check them out right now, starting with our friends at Dometic, a 33-litre icebox valued at $159. Dometic Mobile Living Made Easy voucher thanks to Hepburn Bathhouse and Spa. Unwind in luxury Victoria's world-famous spa country, plus two nights accommodation at any Big Four across Australia. Some fantastic locations. Big Four, the home of great breaks, and with thanks to McCafe, a nice little voucher there heading in to try their finest barista-made coffee ever. Well, let's hope that you can get the win next week. Is that the feeling? It's obviously a result like yesterday. We'll sit in the gut for a few days yet.
Yeah, definitely will. But we'll get back up there today and tonight, and then on the track tomorrow, do the review and then get stuck into Carlton.
Good stuff. Thanks for joining us both.
Cheers, thanks.
All right, good luck to GWS this year. After this short break, we will catch up with Carlton's Darcy Vessio. She's standing by in the McCafe. More with her and to analyse the big match Friday night after this break. We're back on Women's Footy. Good morning to you, wherever you might be joining us. Well, Friday night, it was such a great occasion and a great night for the Carlton Footy Club. Darcy Vessio was there and starred on the field. She joins us now. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
Well, you must be a happy lady this morning, as you were on Friday night, to get the points and get one over Steph and the Magpies.
Yeah, it was a tough game, but yeah, woke up on Saturday and had the win, so that was good.
Yeah, sensational.
Yeah, it was a fantastic night for you. We mentioned Taylor Harris earlier and there was sort of a few questions obviously early in the piece of how you two were going to work together in the forward line, but gee, it worked beautifully, didn't it?
Yeah, Taylor had a great night. I think you saw just how dangerous she is up in the air and on the ground as well, and her tackling pressure was pretty unbelievable too. So yeah, I just sat back and watched, so it was good for me.
Well, you had a front row seat as well, Steph. How did you find Nicola Stevens?
Yeah, look, obviously it's well documented. She left the Pies and she wanted opportunities through the midfield, and I noticed she did start on the wing and play through the midfield throughout the night. How she adapted to that role?
Yeah, I think she's adapted really well. Nick's obviously super skillful, very quick, and gives us a lot of drive through that midfield, I guess, area. It's good having her being able to hit inside 50 as well.
How do you find the physicality of the encounter? It was a really hard night, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was pretty rough out there. I don't know, Chotch probably felt a few too. Yeah, I think the girls are just getting fitter and stronger, so the hits are harder. Certainly felt it out there, but it was a good contest. Like, I think that's what people love, like watching women's footy, it's the contest and how hard we hit.
But also, I mean, Collingwood and Carlton, the rivalry doesn't get any more heated. Does it go up a gear? It's a season opener, and you are old rivals too.
Yeah, it certainly does, and we see it in the men's game, and that's transferred straight across to the women's game, and it obviously started last year, and there's definitely a bit of niggle out there. You just have to look at the first bounce, and, you know, girls are knocking into each other and falling over left, right and centre, and, you know, free kicks paid here and there. So, look, we love that, and I think it's great for our game. Yeah. And, you know, we mean business when we're out there.
Darcy, can you tell us a little bit about Madison Gay? We saw her do some really special things on Friday night. Obviously, she's come across from netball and she's using some of her skills in her footy.
Yeah, Mads was another one who had a great night. I think you can see her netball skills transferring with her marking skills as well. Yeah, she handles a footy just as well as she handles a netball. But, yeah, I think Maddie's been training really well. She's probably one of the hardest people out on the track, so yeah, she's been great.
Time now for our NAB Rising Star. Of course, NAB supporting history in the making. All you need to do is visit nab.com.au/AFLW. Chloe Malloy, 20 touches at 19 years of age. A lot of composure, played in part on Darcy, and also a great teammate.
Yeah, great teammate, great recruit for us. Look, you know, 19 years of age, but you wouldn't know it. She's got a very calm and level head, and she plays really well, obviously. And she has talent, but I think, you know, talent can only get you so far. And she's lucky enough to have work ethic, and she puts in just as hard as anyone else. And I think she's going to be a star for years and years to come.
Thanks to NAB supporting history in the making, of course. Lauren.
Darcy, obviously, as Steph said there, she spent a little bit of time on you, or probably most of the game, really, in the end. But did you know what to expect, obviously, from a draftee, you know, coming to you?
Yeah, I think she came to me at the start. She was there for bits and pieces, but yeah, Chloe's obviously a great forward, so she understands. I guess she can get into your mind about what you're going to do next and that sort of thing. But yeah, she had a lot of impact in the back line for the Pies, so yeah, she was really good. And yeah, I think she showed glimpses of what's to come, so bit scary.
Bit scary indeed. A 6-point win to the Blues, of course. Let's check out now the Tyre Power votes for our Tyre Power Player of the Year. Bree Davey, 5 votes, followed by Danielle Hardiman and Chloe Malloy in there with 3 votes. Darcy, I want to draw your attention to some vision we've compiled right here. I want to know what's going on in the Carlton change rooms. There are some unusual things going on. Can you explain? Bring us up to date. What was that? Was that a reverse twerk or something?
Yeah.
So you step forward.
I don't know what that was.
A bit of Irish dancing here from Nicola too. She's been showing her skills off by the looks of it.
Yeah, I actually didn't know Nick could do that. So it's good she's showing a bit of a dancing flair. Bree too did well.
Well, look at that.
Do you train?
That's expected from Nat Plain.
It's heaps of fun though, by the looks of it.
Yeah, we do. We have a lot of fun, but I think that's half the thing about footy is that you have a lot of fun in the change rooms, and yeah, you know, hopefully, you know, it's good getting the W's because the questions aren't raised too much.
Hey, speaking of fun, you had a lot of fun with the new NAB campaign. Of course, the History in the Making campaign. Visit nab.com.au/AFLW to check it out. What was it like? Just explain the work that went into making this ad.
Yeah, this was actually insane. There were probably over 100 people on set, so rocked up. I don't know where we were. It was out, filmed on a Gaelic footy field. They had these huge green screens going. I got there, they sort of pinned your hair back, put a stocking over my head, and then fitted the wig. But yeah, it was a heap of fun.
We had
a whole heap of local footy players as well as extras, so it was a lot of fun hanging out with those girls, and yeah, it was a full day shoot.
Yeah, I must say the 70s look really worked for you, Darcy.
Yeah, absolutely
One to think about. We understand that was Katie Brennan's real hair.
Yes, that was not a wig on Katie Brennan's head, so for everyone wondering, that's the real deal. That's what she wakes up like. No perm.
What does it mean to you to be, obviously, you know, a role model for young girls that are coming through the footy pathway?
It's pretty amazing, like, to be in this, I guess, position. You feel responsible, but you also feel really privileged to be able to have a voice and be able to connect with the younger girls as well. And, yeah, I just feel extremely lucky.
The NAB History in the Making ad, you can catch it on the website, of course. What's the reaction been to it? I mean, it's getting fair airplay as well. I see it everywhere, but yeah. What are your family and friends saying?
Yeah, they love it. I think it's pretty cool that they've gone the other way. Obviously, with the men's, they've got the mini legends, and they had a few of us players in there too. But yeah, the way they've sort of paid tribute to the women who played before us, and you know, I'm sure we'd love it if they had a lot of footage of those women playing, but there's not much available, but to sort of recreate that is pretty special, I think.
It's a great ad, a sensational ad, and we love what you're doing out on the park as well for the Blues. Good luck for the rest of the season, Darcy.
Thank you very much.
All right, Darcy Vesio joining us here on Women's Footy. Speaking of which, there's more to come after this very short break. We hope you can stay with us. Sensational for NAB to be supporting women's footy this season. All of the big guns assembled Friday at the NAB footy lunch, including 2017 NAB Rising Star Ebony Marinoff, Lily Mithen, and maybe potential 2018 NAB Rising Star Isabel Huntington. Speaking of Isabel, she'll be debuting for the Western Bulldogs a little bit later today. Here's her thoughts on the year ahead.
For me, yeah, it's a pretty surreal experience. Obviously going into such a great club with the Dogs, I was really happy with that, and playing my first game on the weekend, I think it'll be definitely emotional, but I can't wait.
She's one to watch, Lauren Wood, as we draw our attention to the Doggies and Frio today at the Witten Oval.
She is. She's been made to wait extra long for her debut until 4:35 this afternoon. So she's obviously watched three games play out Friday night and then the two last night. She's had to wait till later today, but she can't wait. It should be a cracker.
Should be a cracker indeed. It was a cracker last night as well, of course. The reigning premiers were done by the Brisbane Lions, who avenged that loss from last year in the grand final by some 12 points in front of what was a great crowd there at Norwood. Were you impressed with what you saw, Steph?
Yeah, I was. I think Brisbane moved the ball really well, but what stood out to me was Frederick Traub and just her hands. Obviously, 10 marks, 7 of them contested. The way that she uses the footy is really good for a tall girl. She's got elite kicking skills and, yeah, she's going to be a force to be reckoned with, and I think the Brisbane Lions are holding good stead.
It was certainly her night last night, and Adelaide coach Beck Goddard admitted as much after the game. When someone's taking 10 marks and 7 contested, it certainly was her night. And, you know, when someone's on a run like that, it's pretty hard to stop them. So I think she was probably best on ground. Jess Wuchner dobbed some pretty crucial goals there. And, of course, the Crows having to do it without Erin Phillips and, of course, Courtney Cramie. So they'll be very much looking forward to them returning.
Surely, Lauren Wood, she will feature in our Tyre Power Player of the Year. The votes, of course, at Tyre Power. Buy three and get one free on selected Falcon tyres, thanks to Tyre Power. The votes, Lauren?
Yeah, Sabrina Frederick-Traub for mine. She's got the 5 there. Kate Lutkins, of course, who we featured last week with the 4. Jess Wuchner, the 2. Leah Kasler, I thought, did a fantastic job on your girl, Sarah Perkins, who struggled with a little bit of a calf issue, it looked like. So we'll be seeking an update on that one. And Ebony Marinoff, she's just a tackling machine. So we've given her one vote there in the losing side.
Early days yet, but this is the leaderboard. How it's shaping up right now. Of course, you've got a few big names in there. Of course, Davey Cranston and also Pierce, as well as your girl there, Sabrina Frederick Traub. So one to watch right through the year. Thanks to our friends at Tyre Power for that. Time now to check in with Amy Cattrell. She's teaching the new wave of Victoria police officers. At night, though, it's a far different story.
My name's Amy Catterall. I'm a senior constable at Victoria Police. I'm an instructor at OSS, then also a head coach at Williamstown for the women's BFL for 2018. So get there. Good, good, good. You go where you give it. You go where you give it. So you'll be front and centre now. What I really like about working here at OSS is that I get to help develop people, which I find it motivates me to help people get better. It's good for me to deliver something that might help them in certain situations. So, you know, everyone tends to go back to the training that they were given, whether they realise it or not. They just had a role-playing offender and we just went through the basic skills and, you know, making sure that everyone's keeping on top of those basics. So there's about 20 instructors. I'm the only female here. Yeah, they're really good. They're super inclusive. You know, we're might be different ranks, but we all treat each other the same because we're here for the same purpose. We're here to do the same thing. So we work together as a team to achieve the goal that we set out to do from the start of the day. We switch it back in, and then what do we have there? Front and centre. Front and centre runs it down, leading forward, okay? Kick it to them, take a mark, push back, have a crack at goal. It's windy, get used to it. We play at Williamstown. I think the opportunities for me were what brought me to Williamstown, so we have a chance to create something brand new. For me, it's more about the culture. So are we setting a good example for the younger girls? Are the more mature players being those good role models? Are we creating that secure environment, the safe environment for people to, you know, come down to the club, feel like it's a home?
Amy's such a strong leader because of the way she communicates with everyone. She's very firm with her directions, and everything that she needs to communicate to us just comes across really well.
It is a big jump coming from where you're coming from to VFL level.
Yeah.
But you want to play AFLW, no doubt. Yeah, so we're going to start now. Yeah, and then the quicker you get into AFLW, the longer you play. I guess with Vic Pohl, the training's there and you just follow the plan where I make the plan when I come here. So, you know, it's really up to me whether it works or it doesn't work. I love to help people and I love to see people improving themselves, and it makes me enthusiastic about coming to training and sharing my knowledge of the game.
Thanks for joining us on Women's Footy. We're in the home stretch right now. Let's focus our attention on the great competition that is Supercoach. Of course, play your mates at Play for Keeps at supercoach.com.au. Over to you, Lauren Wood, because you are the resident expert.
Plenty of bragging rights on the line. The banter's already started in the Herald Sun offices. That's right, 50k on the line. But you can register your team at supercoach.com.au now. Fresh new website. And if you do need a hand picking your team, which I know I do each and every year, plenty of word from our supercoach experts at heraldsun.com.au. But we might have one on the desk here, because Steph, I know you play supercoach and you've been training with the Collingwood boys a couple of times over the summer at the Holden Centre. And were there any smokies, any cash cows we might need to look out for that are must picks?
Yeah, I reckon Hoskin Elliott is a must pick. I like the way he plays. I try to model my game on him, and I think he uses the ball really, really well. And I think he's had a really good pre-season, but little Dacos, little firecracker up forward. I think he's going to have a good season.
What was it like training, that big training session you had with the netballers and also the AFL men?
Yeah, unfortunately I couldn't train because I had to go to work, but the girls that did train, about 15 of them, said it was phenomenal. And I think the girls learn a lot from the boys, but the boys also learn a lot from the girls. And just, you know, getting an insight from the boys that have played the game for a little bit longer than us was really valuable.
Let's check out the headlines from round one, because there are so many big talking points. Steph Chiocci, the hot seat is yours first up. What's your headline?
Yeah, I'll go with the Brisbane-Adelaide game. I'm going to go Zilke Smooth. So Emma Zilke, obviously their captain, she responded really well after, you know, suffering a pretty horrific injury last year in the All-Stars game where she punctured a lung and broke a rib. And she was out there, 18 touches, really led the way for the Brisbane Lions. And, yeah, really happy to see her back out there.
Lauren?
Yeah, I'm going with Izzy Huntington. We mentioned her before. Izzy, she the real deal?
Ooh,
I think
like it.
She is. She's the number one draft pick. She's making her debut this afternoon, and she's just got a really levelled head on her shoulders. She's experienced at junior level and, of course, with the Melbourne University Football Club. So I think she'll be the real deal, as it were. There's a great feature on her and a couple of the other Bulldogs, Young Pups by Eliza Sewell in today's Herald Sun. So if you don't know much about them, make sure you check that one out.
Mine is Rocky Road to Glory. I think Rocky is the lady to steer the Demons to a premiership in 2018. We saw her silky skills on show just yesterday in that great win over the Giants. She was sensational, the match winner, of course. Hey, speaking of headlines, one which has just gone a little bit unnoticed, Engaged. Congratulations, Lauren Wood, during the week. You got a sparkler.
Thank you. You can't get away with anything around here,
no,
can you?
No, you can't. No, you must have been wrapped.
Yeah, very, very exciting. A nice surprise, and turned what was already a big week with round one, made it even bigger.
Very quickly, tip today, Dogs or Dockers?
Dogs for me.
Steph?
It's going to be tight, but Bulldogs for me.
Sensational work today. We look forward to seeing you right through the season, as are we. You and your company, we really do appreciate it today. Keep up to date on the social media. Until next week, it's goodbye.